Yo, what is up, guys? I'm back. Double upload today. Just want to say something. I want to make this video as fast. I don't want it to be long. But, yeah, let's get to it. So, Dead by Daylight, they put this on their Discord. And today, they put this on their Discord today. And an update is coming. So, that being said, we're going to be expecting a lot of new things. I'm not going to lie. What I watched for this update looks nice. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, it actually looks nice. Like, there's so much to talk about. I'm gonna just get to it right now. So starting off with the first thing that they have is Clown. So Clown is getting an update. I'm not sure how I entirely feel about it, because it's like, I like it, but it's kind of like, why? Like what was the point? Like. like I don't know how to explain it, but like, basically the Clown's update is like, instead of him only having the bottles that make you slow down, he can switch between another bottle that's yellow, and when he throws it, both the survivor and the killer clown can walk into that yellow smoke. And it'll give you speed. I don't know how much speed, but it'll give you speed. It's right here, actually. It says, anyone who steps in the gas receives a 10% movement speed bonus. So it's like, you get to move a little bit faster. And I feel like it seems cool, but if you think about it, it's like, imagine someone who likes a bloodlust because they're struggling. They're gonna use that to their advantage. So bloodlust plus, you know, clown. You know, that's kind of crazy. I'm not saying that that's what people are gonna do, because that would be a dumb tactic to try to win. But I'm just saying, like, you know what I'm saying. So that's Clown's update. There's other. They also have updates for some perks. I know Undying is one of them. I don't remember the others. They didn't really talk about it in the video. They just said Undying is one of the perks that are going to be updated. I don't know how or in what way, but yeah. Then you got the HUD update. So this is the killer's POV. Like, they changed it to where what do you call it? Instead of our names usually being down here with the generator, you know, the generator count being right above it, the generator count is right here. And then you got all the survivor names, and it shows you who you're playing as. So it's like, you know, the killer really can't get mixed up for, you know, whoever. So I mean, I kind of like this, you know, I kind of like it, but you know, I'm gonna miss this, you know, the whole thing being down here, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, they also have this little circle thing right here for the killer. So like, it takes 3 hooks to kill a survivor, because like, you'd have to put them on once, and then you gotta put them on a second time, and then you gotta put them on a third time to confirm it. So 3, 6, 9, 12, right? This right here, this little icon or whatever, this allows the killer to see how many hooks they've gotten so far. So basically, it'll be like, oh, you have this. It basically, like every tick mark that you can see possibly would add on to like how many hooks you have. Also, they have where whenever like a survivor gets put on hook, so say Nancy gets put on hook, a little tally mark will come up on the side of her name, and it will say like, it will be red. So that will mean she's been hooked one time. And if she gets put on hook again, then 2 red tally marks are going to be there. So that means she's been on hook twice, which means if she goes on a third time, she's going to be dead on hook. Because, like, you know how, like, normally if you're playing Survivor, sometimes you don't remember how many times you've been on hook. Now they have where both the killer and you, I assume, can see how many times you've been on hook. So it's better to make smarter game decisions. So, if, like, everybody been on hook and somebody hasn't been on, like, twice or whatever, or once, or needs to take chase, then you could go tell them, oh, everybody's been on hook this many times, you go take chase or whatever. So I kind of like that, you know what I'm saying. I like it personally. I really do like it. Then you got the new HUD change. I'm not gonna lie, I don't like seeing the item right here. I really hate seeing the item right here. Like, something about it just makes me not like it, like, at all. But it's whatever. They also have where whenever a survivor gets hit, their character would like the character, like if it was David or if it was Elodie, like her icon would blink red to show that she's injured and that she needs to be healed. But yeah, that's pretty much it as far as I can say for the HUD change. Oh, you can also change the size. So if this is too small, you can make it a little bigger. If it's too big, you can make it smaller. If the same thing goes with the perks and the key. So if you want to like have more of a view to see things clearly, you can make all this smaller. Okay, so yeah, it's right here, UI skill options. So yeah, okay. Sorry. So they also have a they have new animations. Let's see if I could pull it up without it being too much or being slow or whatever. They have oh, okay, here we go. They have new animations. I don't know if you'll be able to hear it. They have new animations. Oh yeah, you can hear it. I'll wait for the music because I don't know if it's too loud over me talking. If it's blurry, I am sorry. I could probably change the. Oh, didn't mean to do that. I'm using my PlayStation right now, so. Okay, so my stuff is glitching out. I'm just not gonna play any of the videos because I'm literally like doing this from my console. I like for some reason I wanted to record through my PC, but it wouldn't work, so I tried to do it from my console. And it's the only way I can possibly do it right now. But anyways, there's new animations. So there's a new animation when you're like getting up from the dying state, and it's like weird. And like you know how like normally when you're in the dying state and like when you use Unbreakable or somebody picks you up, you instantly like glitch up and then you could just move. They have a new animation where your character physically like gets up. And I'm thinking, is that a good animation? Because is it an animation where you can't do nothing, you gotta wait till you fully get up, or like can you get up as or can you start moving as you're getting up? Because if that's the case, then we're fine. If it's not, then I don't know, they're gonna have to fix something. But anyways, moving on. So the rank system is totally different now. Like when I say totally different, I mean it's totally different now. So rank now literally means nothing, okay? So they have where if you reach rank one by the end of the month when rank reset resets, it's gonna put you all the way back to rank 20. So that's how it is now. That's literally how it is. You could be rank one for like so long, and then by the time the 13th comes around for rank reset, you're going straight back to 20. But even though you're going back to 20, if you were rank one, you're getting 200. You're getting an additional 250 blood points, and this goes for both survivor and killer. So if you were rank one for killer and survivor, then 250 plus 250, that's 500. That's 500k blood points right there, easy 500k blood points. So yeah, so definitely gonna be a grind. I'm not gonna lie, cause to be for like to go from rank 20 to rank one for both, you're gonna have to like main one literally, cause you're gonna have to put a lot of hours in just to be rank one for both, cause it takes long just to get to red rings. Well, it doesn't take long, but it's quite some time. It's quite some time. So yeah, but that's it for rank pretty much. So yeah, but new graphics update, you know what I'm saying? I love these graphics, bro. I love these graphics, bro. Look at the pig map. Look at pig's map, bro. I want to play on pig's map so bad now. Like, it looks so nice. You know how pig's map be so dark and you can't see nothing? Oh my gosh, bro. It looks amazing, bro. It looks amazing. It looks so beautiful. I'm ready to play. I am so ready to play, bro. When the PTB comes out, you best believe I'm streaming that. So, hey, if you're trying to see that, watch my stream because I'm gonna be streaming it. Trust and believe. Trust and believe. And then you gotta. I don't know what map this is. I really don't remember. It's that. It's Is this Clown's map? Nah, it's not Clown's map. I forgot which map this is. This is the one with that one big building in the middle, and then that's it. And then there's like nothing else around on the outside, except for Shaq, and that was it. But yeah, this is that one building. This is getting updated. And let's see what else. There's an update for Wraith, where are you, when Wraith is like, all right, so like you know how like Wraith, you can see like he'll be invisible, and when he moves, you can see him moving while he's invisible. So if he's 24 meters away from you cannot see him at all. So he could be like he'll be like, and he'll be 24 meters away. Like normally 24 meters away, when you see a Wraith, he's visible clear as day to you, and you'll know to just start running. Now it's like he'll be 24 meters away, and he'll be sitting there looking at you, think finding a way to probably flank around to perfectly attack you, and you won't know at all because he, like his invisible cloak, you normally see it moving. Now it's not going. Now it's like you won't be able to see him. You know what I'm saying? So that's basically how it is. Trapper has a new update also. So normally it takes long sometimes for yourself to get out of traps. So now they have where like the most you can attempt is six. So like one through six times to try to attempt, I mean to try to escape from a trap. So basically it's like you can, I mean they said that in the video that six you probably won't be struggling that much. Like it's rare to get six, but you can get six. So yeah, that's pretty much it. They got a deep wound adjustments. They never really talked about this. Reasonable 30-second timer now seems a little too generous. We will be simplifying deep wounds. The deep wound timer will now 20 seconds long. Wait. It's now 20 seconds long, regardless of how it was applied. The Legion's islands that remove deep wound time have been adjusted accordingly. We wanted to add a bit more urgency to mending while also leaving room for edge cases. Okay, I'm not sure what that means really. Oh, here's the perks that there was. I can't talk. Here's the perks that they were talking about. So, fixated. Don't you hate when you get wait. Don't you hate when you get hit so hard that you forget how to walk slightly faster? Us two, fixated will now remain active even if you're injured. Okay, so they just changed where fixated didn't work before if you were injured or something. I don't know. I know I don't really use the perk. I used it one time when I got Nancy, and that was it really. Let's see what they did for Undying. We've been watching this. Okay. Transferring the same hex multiple times can get out of hand. Hexes are meant to be strong perks that can be destroyed, and having to destroy the same hex four times can be a bit much since tokens aren't transferred from, I mean, since tokens aren't transferred when a hex changes totems. Undying was unpopular with perks other than Ruin, which does not have any tokens and is immediately a full power. Having an aura reading on all totems also is a very powerful tracking perk on top of other effects, and is a little redundant with Hex Thrill of the Hunt. So what are they doing? Anytime a Hex totem is cleansed, it will replace the Hex Undying totem. Hex Undying is deactivated. This ensures that the first totem cleansed is never your other Hex perk. Any tokens you've already accumulated are now kept when the hex perk transfers totems. This way you are not starting from scratch partway through a match. Aura reading only applies to dull totems. Oh, okay, so when if somebody's breaking your lit totem, you won't be able to see that they're doing that. You can only see if they're breaking a dull totem. Okay. I mean okay. Let's see, Iron Maiden. It can be very difficult to follow up a hit on a spider within 50 seconds of them exiting a locker. So we're increasing the duration of the exposed status effect for 30 seconds. It's not bad. It's not bad. Still, all depends on how how close they are. Sorry. Open-handed. For some builds, but the loss value. To convince other survivors to stack to see any noticeable results. To make this more appealing, Choice will be increasing the aura reading range bonus to 8, 12, 16 meters by limiting you to the effects of the open hand. I really don't use this perk. Second wind, another simple one. We are reducing the time it takes to for second wind to heal you after being unhooked. Not sure what this means either, but I don't, because I don't really use these perks. But that's gonna wrap up this video. I'm gonna hope that this video isn't long, at least like 10 minutes the most. I don't want it to be long, because I know like if an update came out, I wouldn't be wanting to like watch a long video on them talking about what's the update for DBD. So that's all the DBD's updates. When the live update happens, I will be streaming. So if you want to come to my stream and, you know, play with me for the new update or whatever, hey man, join the stream and I got you. We're playing. Trust me. So yeah, if you're new though, feel free to subscribe. You know, help me out. It's a new channel. My new channel. I'm trying to get up there. You know what I'm saying? I've been posting daily. And today's a double upload. I already posted Shrine Circuits today. And now I'm posting DBD update. So help me out, subscribe, turn on post notifications. You know what I'm saying? I got a doctor video coming out tomorrow. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed.